Every song you love has been carefully shaped, not just by instrument and voices, but by tools that control loudness, softness, and everything in between. These tools can highlight the best parts of music, adding life, energy, and detail. Or they can completely reshape sound in surprising ways. So what are these tools? We call them dynamic processors. Dynamic processors are the unsung heroes of music production. They respond to the amplitude of a signal. That's the actual size of the waveform, and not just how loud or quiet something feels. This distinction is important, because while amplitude is often linked to perceived loudness, if we zoom in, dynamic processors can actually reshape the waveform itself, and even change its timbre. Today, we'll break down the different types of compression, and we'll show you exactly how they work using the most versatile dynamic processor there is, the Omnipressor. Before we get into it, we need to understand there are two sides to dynamic processing, shape controls and time controls. We can find the shape controls on the right side of the Omnipressor. These determine which type of processing we apply, its intensity, and limit how much reduction or increase in level is allowed. On the left side, we have the time controls. These determine the split point between high amplitude and low amplitude, how fast it should react, and how fast it should recover. This video will be all about the shape controls. If you would like to learn about the time controls, check out the link in the description below. Let's dive in. Let's start with the most common type, compression. Compression will reduce dynamic range. It will bring high and low amplitude closer together. When we bring down high amplitude parts, that's anything above the threshold, we call that downward compression. This can add body to a vocal or make a beat more consistent. Just make sure that the gain limit is set to zero and attenuation is engaged. When we want to retain some dynamics, we can mix in the unprocessed signal and then blend it to taste. This technique is called parallel compression. If the ratio, which is the intensity of the compression, is infinite, we will get a brick wall limiter, which is great for avoiding clipping or unwanted distortion. So what about lifting the low amplitude parts? Or in other words, compressing anything below the threshold? All we need to do is to allow the Omnipressor to add gain, but tell it not to reduce level at all. This can be a great choice when wanting to emphasize the room sound, or recover details of a performance without affecting the peaks. Now, if we allow both gain and attenuation while the function is set to compress, meaning we're using both types of compression at the same time, then the dynamic range starts to rotate toward a horizontal line. This is known as full range compression. This could be useful when more natural compression is needed, like a dynamic string performance recorded in a good sounding room. Next, we have expansion. You can think of expansion as the opposite of compression. Instead of bringing the ends of the dynamic range closer together, we're widening the gap between them. In other words, although this is not technically correct, we're making the low parts lower and the loud parts louder. Now, to create downward expansion, which means turning things down below the threshold level, we need to, of course, set the function to expand and then tell the Omnipressor not to add any gain and to engage the attenuation instead. Just like we saw with compression, downward means engaging the attenuation limit. This is arguably the most common type of expansion. It's often used to add dynamics to a flat performance, or if taken to the limit, to create a noise gate, effectively muting quiet parts like background noise. Oh. To draw attention to the loud parts of a song, you will need upward expansion. This means turning things up above the threshold. So while keeping the function set to expansion, reverse the limit knobs to allow gain to be applied. Now imagine you're working with a sample, but it has been overly compressed downwards. Upward expansion is a great way to undo this type of compression. It can also be helpful when a singer needs a bit of extra power during the chorus.
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know.
If we increase attenuation and gain while expanding, the dynamic range will rotate toward a vertical line, giving us full range expansion. This can be a nice creative approach, especially if we adjust the limit knobs. For example, we could set it so an electric guitar stays in the background during the verses and moves forward during the chorus, all while keeping the natural dynamics. The last type of dynamic processing we'll look at is often called negative compression. This name can be misleading. It doesn't mean the opposite of compression. We know that's expansion. It's just describing a negative ratio. Just like standard compression, high amplitude is reduced and low amplitude is increased. The twist is that both attenuation and gain go beyond the threshold, effectively turning dynamics upside down. This is why Eventide uses the term dynamic reversal, which is a way more accurate description. Downward reversal, which is a negative ratio with attenuation engaged, can act like a ducker, softening transients to make room for other sounds, or turning a boring snare into an organic transition. Upward reversal can emphasize hidden details while keeping transients natural, like a lush pad in a layered piano patch. Enable both gain and attenuation, and the whole dynamic range flips on its side, completely reversing the balance. This is particularly interesting for turning crescendos into diminuendos, or at a finer scale, mellowing a plex timbre while adding some bounce to it. Full dynamic reversal is one of the most creative sides of the Omnipressor, so it's worth experimenting with extreme settings. We've covered a lot: compression to smooth things out, expansion to add contrast, and dynamic reversal to turn dynamics upside down. They all are different approaches, but they all serve the same purpose: to make music more expressive. These aren't just tricks. These tools can completely reshape the life of a track. So always remember, only use these tools to serve the song. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to Eventide's channel. Until next time, stay curious.